So a long, long time ago, and essentially true, is a parallel story. So first the grandmother and grandfather fall in love. They make it through the war. They decide that they're going to go pursue their dreams in this golden city of Krakow that they've heard about. And then it doesn't quite work out for them. I had never thought of the book as a love story. And I was telling one of my friends that it had been described as a love story, and I really think that it's a love story, but it's about my love story for Krakow. I just absolutely was taken by the city. I went to these things called milk bars, which are basically subsidized lunch places. And they're great because it's socially acceptable to sit down at a table with complete strangers. So I would go to these milk bars, sit down at a table by, you know, a lonely old person and kind of trap them, so then they would have to talk to me. And I found that eventually, you know, there were all these people out there who just wanted to tell their stories. You know, when I got home, I started telling my own stories and the stories that I had heard, and there was just so much. So I just started to write them all down, and that's the one thread of the book with Baba Yaga in it. Comes directly from a list that I made of just things in Krakow that I didn't want to forget. There are two things that are true about the World War II thread. The first one is, you know, how the pigeon looks and how the pigeon acts is how I imagine that my grandfather would have acted if he were living at that time. So I really had him in my mind for the character of the pigeon. I didn't know him very well. He died when I was about 10, but I kind of invented this life for him in the mountains of Poland. 50 years later, the granddaughter, who's heard all the stories that her grandmother's told her about the golden city of Krakow, goes to repeat the journey at a similar transition point, just after communism as opposed to just after the war. And she goes to Krakow, and instead of finding this golden city, she sees a lot of disaffected youth and a lot of difficulties with the transition into capitalism. I stole the title from myself. It was actually the title of a collection of Russian stories that I had written, and it's a literal translation, or my bad literal translation, of Once Upon a Time, which is Это было очень давно и это существенная правда. And that's in Russian. And I stole it from the Russian collection because I thought it really fit this book in terms of the fairy tale that was kind of sold to Poland. So after the war, you know, this was, communism was kind of a fairy tale propagated by the Russians and transplanted into Poland, and it didn't turn out with a fairy tale ending. You know, I was a little bit lost like Baba Yaga for a while, and I did social work for a while, and I went to Russia, lived in Russia for a couple of years, lived in Italy, and throughout that whole time, what happened to me gradually morphed into what was happening to Baba Yaga, and so she was kind of a companion in that way. I took a trip back in 2005. And I went to my favorite cafe there is called Pigeon 3, and that's just its address. I went to this cafe, Pigeon 3, to do some writing. I looked around this pigeon cafe, and there were all these pictures and mobiles of pigeons, and all of a sudden, the story about the pigeon and World War II and Baba Yaga's grandparents' story came to me,